presentation of AIT.
I don't see any tomato sauce, but, well, here's some ketchup.
No, we need more than that. Barbecue sauce. Yeah, that'll work, okay. Wow. We better clean this place up. Look, just pour the barbecue sauce into the pan and turn up the heat. Great, you turned on the wrong burner. Oh, now the sauce will never be ready in time.
That magnet looks hot. Well, it's too hot to touch. I mean, how are we gonna get it off the burner?
Hold on.
You know, Kevin, that is one pretty ugly magnet.
Well, it's my mom's favorite. She says it has sentimental value.
How can a refrigerator magnet have sentimental value?
You don't know my mother.
I don't see the attraction.
Let's check the sauce. Hey, that's weird.
What?
Well, this magnet, it won't stick anymore.
Oh, come on.
See? Watch out. Look. Oh, great. We broke my mom's favorite magnet. Now what are we gonna do?
What if we just replaced it?
Are you kidding?
Yeah. Hey, what if we took it to Rollo? Maybe he could fix it.
Yeah, Rollo. He can fix anything.
Yeah.
We'll go to the lab after dinner.
Okay. You smell something burning?
It's supposed to smell that way.
I don't know about that. Maybe you should taste it.
Okay. Yeah, that's perfect. Hey, Rollo, we've got a problem.
The weirdest thing happened, and it was not our fault.
It fell, and then it stopped working. Can you help?
What are you guys talking about?
Well, my dad said he was going to be late, and he wanted to know if we could start dinner. Mm-hmm. So Mark and I were cooking spaghetti.
Hey, you guys were cooking spaghetti?
Yeah.
It turned out pretty well.
Well, his dad took one bite and got the sudden craving for Mugu Gai Pan, but other than that...
Okay, so maybe we put in a little bit too much barbecue sauce.
Barbecue sauce? That's your problem.
No, this is our problem. My mom's favorite magnet fell off the range hood and onto the stove.
Your mom has a favorite magnet?
Well, he says it's got sentimental value.
It does?
Yeah, it does. Well, when it fell on the stove, Mark turned up the wrong burner, and the magnet got really hot.
Yeah, and after it cooled down, it wouldn't stick anymore.
Uh-huh. My mom's really gonna freak out when she finds out we broke her favorite magnet. Can you help?
Maybe, but we have to find out first what happened to it.
Well, we already know that. It doesn't stick anymore.
Yeah, well, what made it stop sticking?
That's what we're asking you.
I'm not just going to give you the answer. Well, then you'd miss the thrill of the exploration. Now, what do you think made the magnet lose its attraction?
Well, it fell, and then it got hot. So one of those two things must have done it.
Yeah, could it be a combination of the two?
Well, maybe. How could we find out what broke the magnet?
Well, we might have to recreate what happened in the kitchen.
Sounds good. Let the exploration begin.
Now, let's try dropping it.
Yeah, it still works.
So the heat must have done it.
Yeah, we'll have to test that.
Okay. See, I told you the heat must have done it.
Yeah, but why would the heat make the magnet stop working?
How could you answer that?
We might need to know more about how a magnet works.
Well, what do you know about magnets?
Well, they stick to things, you know, like refrigerators.
Yeah. Well, you might need to know a little bit more than that. How could you find out some more?
Wait, don't tell me. We're going to have to explore some more.
That's a great idea. I told you this would be thrilling. I've got some magnets around here that just might do the trick. Enjoy.
Thanks. Yet we're still playing.
I told you this would be thrilling, but you can't play with magnets for the whole show. This is the part where we talk about what you found. Oh. So what have you found?
Well, magnets come in all different shapes and sizes. Well, look, even this rock is a magnet.
Yeah, you see, they all look different, but they all act the same.
How do they act?
Well, magnets stick best to each other on one end.
What do you mean?
Well, look, the different colored ends attract, and the same colored ends repel.
Mm-hmm. You see, those are the north and south poles.
Right, so different poles attract, and similar poles push away. Well, look, that's why I can do this. Isn't that cool?
Well, do both sides of the magnet attract other things?
Well, yeah, look, both sides of the magnet pick up stuff.
Yeah, but only if it's metal.
Well, I can pick this up, and it's plastic.
Yeah, but it's got a metal wire in it.
Oh, yeah.
You see, but magnets don't pick up all metal. See, it picked up these paper clips. But it didn't pick up this aluminum foil.
Well, does a magnet have to be touching something to have an effect on it?
Oh, no, look. I can make this one magnet move just by moving the other magnet.
Uh-huh. I can make these magnets stick right through my finger.
Oh. Well, what does that tell you?
Well, a magnet must give off something that attracts certain objects. Mm-hmm. Well, it seems to extend around the magnet in all directions.
Yeah, but what would it give off?
Well, let's see. Now remember, I'm a trained professional. Don't try this at home.
Why not?
Well, it could pretty much trash your TV.
So why are you doing it?
Well, because I'm the surrogate instructor. TV's only a prop.
Oh, okay.
Oh, look at that. What is that?
Is that what the magnet gives off?
Well, it's more like its region of influence.
You mean it's like the area where the magnet has pulled?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's called a magnetic field.
Here we go.
Well, there's like a different pattern of lines for each type of magnet.
Huh, and the effect gets smaller as you move away.
Well, wait a minute. This one doesn't do anything. So what causes magnetism anyway? Well,
let's see.
What are those?
Well, one's a magnet.
How do you know?
Well, because we're talking about magnets, and you wouldn't show us pictures of two different things if one wasn't a magnet.
Kevin, your powers of logic are amazing. What's different about them?
Well, the arrows in one are all lined up, and the arrows in the other are pointing in all directions.
Well, which one's the magnet?
Well, the one where the arrows are pointing mostly in the same direction.
That's right.
Well, what are those little sections, and what makes them line up? Are those the atoms?
Well, those are the atoms that make up one section.
Oh, and the things spinning around them, those are the electrons.
Yeah.
It looks like the atom's electrons are spinning mostly in the same direction.
And that's what makes things magnetic, electrons spinning in the same direction?
You got it.
So the more electrons spinning in the same direction, the stronger the sections?
Yeah, but they're called magnetic domains.
Hmm. Oh, so the more sections or domains that line up, the stronger the magnet?
Yeah.
Why did the magnet stick to the metal range hood?
Well, the range hood isn't a magnet, and we know that they didn't attract each other.
So why do magnets stick to things that aren't magnetized?
Well, it looks like the domains in the range hood are lining up slightly when the magnet's brought closer.
Yeah, they line up just like they do in the magnet. That's what made it stick to the range hood, right?
Yeah.
Well, what would happen if you took the magnet away from the range hood? Would the range hood stay magnetized?
The domains in the range are going back to normal. Well, almost. They still look a little magnetized.
Mm-hmm. Why don't magnets stick to everything?
What do you mean?
Well, they stick to range hoods, refrigerators,
and yeah, sometimes.
Well, yeah, but they don't stick to everything.
Well, not everything has magnetic domains.
Why not?
Well, it depends on the atoms that make up the substance.
So if a substance doesn't have domains, then the magnet doesn't affect it?
Yeah.
So why do magnets have two poles? The tips of the arrows are the north, and the ends are the south.
When the domains are going mostly in the same direction, that's when they create the poles?
Mm-hmm. So the pointy side of the arrow is only attracted to the blunt side of the other arrows?
Yeah, well, everybody knows opposites attract. Yeah.
And similar ends repel. Well, what would happen if you split a magnet in half? Would you have two magnets with only one pole?
That's a good question.
Well, it might take some elbow grease, but let's see if we can cut this magnet into two pieces.
Well, how are we going to do that?
You want us to cut the magnet with a hacksaw?
Mark, scientific discovery is 1% inspiration, 99% perspiration. This is the perspiration part.
Barolo, we're done with the perspiration part.
Hey, look, both pieces act like little magnets.
Yeah, why didn't they break in half with one piece being north and the other being south?
Well, can you ever have a magnet with only one pole?
Well,
let's go look at the model.
Both pieces still have domains.
And the domains are aligned, and they stay aligned.
Well, they're set in two poles when they stay that way.
Hey, wait a minute, two poles. The Earth has two poles.
Yeah, the North and South Pole, so what?
So, is the Earth a magnet?
That's a good question. Let's see.
Oh, that shows us a lot about magnets.
Well, work with me. Kevin, would you put that magnetized needle on top of this piece of cork?
Yeah, sure.
Let's see, it's moving.
Can you guys make it point in any other direction?
Huh. Hey, it doesn't point in any other direction.
How could you explain that?
Well, maybe the magnetic needle is affected by the Earth's pole.
Well, it's affected by the Earth's magnetic pole.
That's how a compass works. Mm-hmm.
So you mean a compass points north because it's attracted to the Earth's magnetic pole?
Yeah, it's affected by the Earth's magnetic field.
Magnetic field, and that's what we saw on the television.
Hey, you know, I think I'm really getting the hang of this magnetism stuff.
Well, let's see about that. Would you bring me that coil of wires there by the TV?
Yeah. You mean these right here? Hey, check it out.
What is that?
Hey, wait a minute. This thing's plugged into the wall. Why does it do that?
Well, I thought you had the hang of this. Can you tell me?
I guess not.
Well, take a look at this. I'm going to hook this wire up to a battery.
Why would the battery affect the compass?
Well, it's a magnet, so maybe the electricity from the battery made it move.
What? Well, why would electricity affect the magnet?
Watch.
What are you doing now?
Just trying to wrap up this magnetism stuff. Now, the nail's not a magnet, the wire's not a magnet, and the battery's not a magnet. But look what happens when I put all three together.
Hey, the electricity made the wire a magnet. Well, that's what happened with the coil of wires over by the television.
Yeah. How could you explain that?
Well, maybe the electricity from the battery screwed up the way the domains in the wire line up.
Well, there aren't any domains in the wire.
Well, wait a minute. How can you have a magnet without domains?
Yeah. Well, electricity is another way of making magnetism.
How does it do that?
Well, the motion of the electric current through the wire creates a magnetic field.
And that's what made the compass move. Mm-hmm.
Look, I still don't understand how any of this is going to help me fix my mom's magnet.
What made your mother's magnet stop working in the first place?
Heat.
Well, see, that's what I don't understand. If you can split a magnet in half and still have it work, why would heat make a magnet stop working?
What do you think?
I don't know.
Let's see. Now, what would have to happen for our model magnet to stop being a magnet?
Well, the magnetic domains would have to be scrambled so they didn't line up.
What could do that?
Heat.
Why?
Well, I mean, heat would move the molecules around and that would scramble everything up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what happened to our magnet. The heat scrambled the domains and made it stop working.
Mm-hmm. Watch what happens as we add heat to the magnet. Can you guys think of any other ways to make the domain shift?
Would the same thing happen if you hit the magnet real hard?
What would hitting the magnet do?
Well, hitting it would add energy and maybe shift the domains.
That's good.
So if our magnet had fallen farther, the fall would have demagnetized it?
That makes sense.
Can we make the domains line up again and fix the magnet?
How do you suggest we do that?
Well, maybe if we heat it long enough, they'll go back again.
No. Heat broke it before. Hey, what if we put it next to another magnet?
What do you mean?
I mean, wouldn't the magnetic field of one magnet make the domains of another magnet line up?
Well, that's not gonna work.
Well, let's see about that. Get that other magnet. We'll try rubbing two magnets together.
Okay. This? Like this?
Yeah.
Hey, Rollo, it works. Hey, thanks. You saved my life.
You know, that magnet must not be very strong if a hot burner can demagnetize it.
Well, magnets can vary in strength. I want to show you guys something I've been working with.
Hey, what's the bubbly stuff?
Well, it's called liquid nitrogen.
Gosh, it's cold. I can feel it.
Yeah, it's extremely cold. You have to be very careful when you're working with it.
Well, what are you going to do with that?
Well, let's let it cool down a minute, and I'll show you. Watch. I'm going to put this magnet on top of this ceramic disc.
Wild. What makes it hang up there?
What do you think makes it float in midair?
Well, it must have something to do with the liquid nitrogen.
Yeah, well, heat broke it before. Why would cold do this?
That is so cool.
Why would you even want to do this with a magnet?
Will that work with any other metal or just magnets?
Well, you guys have opened up a whole new area to discover.
Here it comes.
And I think I'll let you enjoy the thrill of exploration on your own.
Can't you at least give us a hint?
No, I don't want to ruin the thrill, but I will give you this.
So what's that?
Well, this is Mama Rolowinski's famous spaghetti sauce recipe.
Yeah, now this will work. Just pour it all in there.
Okay.
Cool.
You know, I'm thinking maybe next time.
Here are some questions for further discussion. Why did the magnet Mark and Kevin dropped on the stove lose its magnetism? Remember when we connected a wire to a battery, then we moved it close to a compass needle and the needle moved? How are magnetism and electricity related? I showed Mark and Kevin the way a magnet could float above a disk in liquid nitrogen. What caused the magnet to float above the superconducting disk? What practical uses could this property have? Enjoy your exploration of the domain of magnetism, and remember to keep your minds on science.
To obtain a copy of the Minds on Science Teacher's Guide, contact your ITV service agency or send $7.50 check or money order to AIT Department Minds on Science, Bloomington, Indiana, 47402-0120.